just never leave, do you?
It's like the Hotel California. You can check out anytime you like.
You could just never leave. I'm from California. We just had a really good conference in there. We talked about what we're going to take on the floor. We got our appropriation bills up. I'm going to bring up the motion to vacate today. We'll do it in the first series and move through this.
Will you still be Speaker of the House by the end of tonight?
You know, if I counted how many times someone wanted to knock me out, I would have been gone a long time ago.
So you're confident? Yes.
Can you explain a little bit about why do it today? I mean, the idea that you
why not?
Rip the Band-Aid off here, or what?
Why not? You know, look, I think Matt has planned this all along. It didn't matter what we transpired. You know, he would have done it if we were in shutdown or not. I firmly believe it's the right decision to keep government open, to make sure our military is still paid, our border agents are still paid. And if that makes a challenge based upon whether I should be Speaker, I'll take that fight.
So you're calling his bluff?
Yeah.
What was your conversation like with Mr. Jeffries? Why did you call him?
Well, I have to talk to Jeffries about a lot of things. We talk every week. We talk sometimes during the week. We've got some issues going on. The Bowman, I always try to let him know what's going to be coming to the floor and others. My only conversation with Jeffries, I got a lot of respect for him. You know, you guys do whatever you need to do. I get politics. I understand where people are. I truly believe, though, the institution of the House. At the end of the day, if you throw a speaker out that has 99% of their conference, that kept government open and paid the troops, I think we're in a really bad place for how we're going to run Congress.
So are you expecting Democrats to back you up then?
No, I personally am not.
Do you need their help to remain in leadership?
No. If five Republicans go with Democrats, then I'm out. So it's
not
whether.
Likely.
Probably so.
This is a bit of a complex piece of algebra here, because you don't know with attendance, you don't know with present votes. I mean, tell me why you're so confident based on what the mathematical equation is.
Because I live in America.
No, I know, but I mean, this is
no.
a serious.
It is a serious question.
Issue.
Have you ever, take the current situation out. Have you ever come to me on no matter what you thought I couldn't solve? That I wasn't confident?
I'm not questioning your confidence.
But you're asking why I'm confident? Because who I am. And I just don't give up. So there are obstacles in my life. I have fallen many times. There was a time I was going to be Speaker and I couldn't, and you guys all counted me out. I'm Speaker. I'm the 55th Speaker of the House. You're confident that government was going to shut down. You were confident the debt ceiling wouldn't get done. But each and every time, if it's an obstacle, I view it as a challenge, and we're going to solve the challenge. We're going to take it heads on.
Are you confident that you'll hold on?
I'm confident I'll hold on.
Do you think this is going to keep coming up repeatedly?
It could. It seems very personal with Matt. It doesn't look like he's looking out for the country or the institution. I mean, I gave this quote away. You ought to read, maybe I'll give it to you later in the process of what can it.
Are you ruling out any sort of power-sharing agreement with Democrats or any sort of deals with Democrats?
That doesn't work. Look, I'm a conservative. I'm a Republican. I'm a conservative one that gets things done. I know we live in our government's designed to have compromise. But look, we're in the majority. You don't surrender. Do you work with the other side? Yeah, and that's what I've done. I mean, from the day I came in, I've always said I'm going to treat Hakeem the way I wanted to be treated. I think you've seen that. Everything doesn't have to be political. And I firmly believe when you look at history, and when I talk to the other speakers like a Boehner or Paul Ryan, the first thing when they would meet, Nancy Pelosi would come and she would simply say to them, if anyone ever did that motion, we would stand with you. Not because of you and not because we agree politically, simply because of the institution needs to be able to stand on its own. First thing she did when she became speaker was she removed that. And you know what? It gave me the power to make that motion on her. I had a lot of Republicans that wanted me to do it. I never did it. Did Nancy and I get along? No, we really don't get along. But I thought the institution was too important, and I thought that was too personal. But you know, at the end of the day, keeping government open and paying our troops was the right decision. I stand by that decision. And at the end of the day, if I have to lose my job over it, so be it. But I'm going to fight for the American public, and I'll continue to fight. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.